Hi, everybody. Welcome to TWR Facebook Live. Happy to be here this morning to answer some of the questions about the sleep yoga practice. So I'm very, very excited that since last 2 days, we have, I think, about 7,000 views in the Facebook Live, and also many beautiful comments, many sharings. So I wanted to thank you all really like with such a enthusiastic and very energized crowd, and also like very actively making comments and sharing. This is also like we are giving feed, how you say, giving energy back and forth. So I'm getting energized with all of your beautiful comments and sharing, participation. So very excited. So how is everybody's sleep? How is everybody's dream? And how everybody is engaging in the practice? So I very much looking forward to hear all of your comments. Did you practice? Did you practices help? Did you sleep well? Did you have some experiences? Or did you sleep better? Are you more restful? Are you better mood in the morning? It seems like your perspective of life is kind of a little bit opening up, clear up, more joyful. What's going on? So looking forward to hearing all of your feedback. And also, it's a very exciting news that our Facebook team has been really working very hard and make sure that everything's working well. The background, back on the scene, there's a lot of things happening. So one thing very exciting is we have 16 languages translation. So we have Spanish, we have French, we have German, we have Hungarian, we have Finnish, we have Danish, we have Dutch, Slovak, Czech, Russian, Korean, Turkish, Italian, Polish, Portuguese, Romanian. So we have 16 different languages, so which is really, really fantastic. I am very, very thankful for all those people who just come forward and volunteering their time. And you know how much it means to people who hear in your language, right? So I think people who are translating, I'm sure you know that. And I think it's also good everybody who are listening in your own languages, send some gratitude, thanks to those people who are doing those volunteering and trying to translate for all of you. So that's wonderful news. So the other day we talked a little bit, you know, the idea of falling asleep with the awareness will change your life. I think that line is kind of really, really important. Maybe if we look at back in our life, last 5-10 years, most of the time during the daytime we think about, oh, how is my life, how is my work, how is my emotion, thinking, and so on. But we don't really question ourselves or ask ourselves deep enough that, how do I sleep? Do I sleep good enough? Do I sleep long enough? Do I have a problem with sleeping? What I can do better? If I'm not sleeping well, if I wake up continuously, when I wake up I cannot go back to sleep, what are the things that I can do to change that? Because sleeping good, sleeping long enough, sleeping with more a sense of really well, I think that's a very, very important part for our well-being, for our health, our psychological, emotional well-being, our mood, our productivity, our creativity, our relation to others. I think it matters a lot. And as modern society, I think there's a lot of problem with the sleep and sleep deprivation. I says not having enough sleep, basically, or not having good enough sleep. So that's a big problem. So I think sleep yoga practices will definitely help you in all those matters. So I think about that, improving your sleep quality, improving your health through your sleep quality, improving your meditation practices through the sleep practices. So that's very important. I know like some of the things I'm repeating again, but these are really important to repeat because we don't hear them enough or hear them deep enough or hear them deep enough to make any changes in our life. So that's why sometimes I repeat these things. So if you are going sleep every night with your pain body, you are going to have pain body related dreams. You are going to have painful body in the morning, and you're going to wake up in a painful world in the morning. So same way, if you go to sleep with a pain speech, a lot of voices in your head, a lot of kind of fears and negativity, activating those voices in your before you go to sleep. So you're going to have that kind of sleep, and you're going to have that kind of morning. You're going to have that kind of day next day. And same way with your mind, if you have your pain mind is very activated, so you're projecting so much things out in your life, thinking, imagining this can happen, that can happen, all those things probably they might never happen, but if even they do happen, there's nothing you can do about it. Thinking negatively, feeling hopeless, helpless with those situations, nothing going to change. So leaving them as they are is the method, as in the teaching it says. So somehow having more like a positive relationship them will be far better. So I think in a way how you fall asleep with your mind impacts so much. So recognizing all those things in your life that for last many years, there's certain very specific certain patterns that you go to sleep, it's probably can be improved. Maybe it's not good. Maybe it's really bad. This is your opportunity to try to look closely, and with the help that I'm trying to provide here, or help the whole Cyber Sangha together here, we are trying to help each other to really like trying to change that in our life. So that's I think very, very important to kind of reflect. There are a few questions, so I will probably go through them, some of them first. So if somebody is saying, is there any possibility to bring awareness during dreaming with this sleep yoga method, or is this teaching only for bringing awareness to deep sleep state? So absolutely, these exercises I'm referring to specifically from Mother Tantra teaching, from sleep yoga practice. It's called a support practice, Pongde, and there are six of them. So all six of them are equally supports dream yoga and sleep yoga. So basically it supports dream and sleep. Not only as a practice of dream and sleep, as mentioned earlier, that it will help your health. It will help your well-being. It will help your psychological state. It will help your mood. It will your emotional state. It will help because it will, why it's going to help? Because it will make you sleep better, more restful, more connected, better quality basically, beyond you are able to be lucid, able to change your dream, able to be in the clear light state. I'm not talking only those things. I'm talking just it will help you to even have a better sleep, better restful. So maybe I would like to ask everybody that next. So since we just started 2 days ago, so last 2 days, how was it? How was your sleep? How was your dream? And I want everybody to really watch these talks and practice this guided meditation and give me feedback, because I am looking at all these feedbacks, and also other people are looking at these feedbacks, all your comments, so that people saying, oh, something is happening to them, they learn from, we all learn from each other's comment, or we inspire each other through the practice, and we support each other. So yes, simple question is, yes, it does help dream, sleep, your sleep quality, your well-being all together. So another question, it says, when energy raises through the central channel and it touches my third eye, I feel pain there like a headache between my eyes. It has happened for many years. What is happening there? So what is happening there? I'm not exactly sure what's happening there, but sometime, you know, it's kind of very natural when you put your finger, when you bring some attention to the third eye, there is some kind of tension there, specifically very, very, very obvious, like a physical tension that you feel there, and that kind of happens. So I'm not really, really sure what's happening there, but maybe it could be that if it's related to the practices, it could be that some things are opening inside you, some maybe central channel is opening inside you. It's possible, depends on a person's, and if it's directly linked with the practices or not. So through these practices, a lot of things are happening. So I think to be open to experiences is important. Third question is, do you exercise in upward position or already lying down? So this is, you can practice these things, upward position, and then you can also lie down, repeat the practice again. So either way, it's fine. But for sure, you wanted to do practices as in a lying position as you do it, because in the last 10 minutes, remember, we talked about that. I want everybody to listen carefully here. Last 10, 15 minutes, before you fall asleep, depends on how fast you fall asleep. And the most important thing is the last moment you fall asleep, your attention, where is your attention? Where is your, what is your, what you are thinking? What is your emotional state? How you are connected and disconnected to yourself? How much you are aware or not aware in you? Your nature of mind, you have some sense of stability, or you have some sense of feeling secure, safe, feeling home. Those feelings and thoughts are very important. So last 5, 10, 15 minutes, it's very important. You don't want it to lose. So that means usually you will be lying down already, and just imagine you're lying down already, and your attention is not going by itself. Your attention, you're aware of what you're thinking, and you are guiding your mind to the practice. So that means, so those you are not familiar, and maybe those you're watching first time, what we are talking here is the last 2 days ago, we give one exercise for before you go to sleep yoga as a part of the sleep yoga practice. This exercise is very simple. This exercise is attention of objects. So attention of objects. So usually our attention to the object, it's very specific patterns that we have, as mentioned earlier, that we tend to focus on what we are worried, tend to focus on what we feel pain, or tend to focus on the people we don't like, people we have conflict with. So you have your own pattern every night you go to sleep. So you're trying to kind of, with the power of your awareness, you're trying to be aware that's what you're doing, and power of your awareness, you're trying to redirect your attention from those negative places to a positive place with the light. The light represents the awareness. So what you're doing as a practice is basically you are trying to dissolve all objects of ego, objects of pain, objects of fear that you usually think you are connected and you are driven by, you are lost in. You are redirecting those objects, focusing on them, but with your power, with your awareness, and dissolving them into the light. That's what you're trying to do. So, for example, this is just an example. I'm trying to go to sleep, so this is a kind of little bit dark, heavy object, my case, glass case. So I imagine maybe I'm very attached to this, or maybe I'm thinking about I need to get better one, or whatever. So imagine I'm almost trying to go to sleep, and then my mind is kind of looking for something to worry about. And then I know my case is not good anymore, it's broken. And then I'm thinking, well, I have a broken case, my glasses might get broken, will be break, you know, so you're worried about that. Suddenly you realize that, oh, I am thinking negative, I'm thinking fear, and then suddenly this is my awareness. So I have not my iPhone, this time I have a torch here. Yeah? I am redirecting my attention to the same object, but not in a negative way, in a positive way. I am trying to bring a sense of awareness there. So I am trying to bring the sense of awareness. So this is the light. So you can see this light. Imagine this light is the awareness, my awareness. When I am looking at any object, and in a negative way, that object become, I have a negative relation to that object, I project on something, I affect that, like idea of, you know, this, sorry, I don't remember the name of Japanese scientist, researcher who wrote a book called Message from the Water, and so the projecting your positive energy or negative energy into the water, and water is frozen, all the shapes, crystal shapes, it forms different when you have positive thought, when you have a negative thought. So I know many of people know that book. So anyway, the point is, this is my awareness. When my awareness is looking into this object, I am somehow, my energy is kind of connected to this, so I'm aware of this. So in the same way, if I'm some place in a discomfort in my body, let's say that I feel hurt, I feel pain in my heart, so physically I feel pain in my heart emotionally, but most of the time when I go to sleep, I don't think so much about it. My mind automatically, as I retrieve my senses inward, my mind automatically become a little weaker, vulnerable, lost, and it kind of affects with that pain in my heart. Or my mind goes directly here, and then some sense of like feeling hopeless, helpless, feeling like that. And suddenly I catch myself feeling that. I'm trying to awake a little bit, awaken awareness, and I'm trying to bring my awareness into my heart, so that you can see the light here. So this light is the light of my awareness. My attention is there. So in that moment, not only my attention is there, my attention has an open quality, my attention has a aware quality of awareness and connectedness. My attention also has a quality of warmth. So what I call spacious, luminous, warm hug. Spacious, luminous, warm presence I am bringing to my heart. So, and then that moment, I'm not losing it. I'm remaining. Then I'm trying to go to sleep. So what does that mean? So basically, that means the attentions are very important. So usually we have our driven attentions are negative, so when our when you're aware of it, that you're trying to change, you have more spacious, luminous, warm attention. So what we do in this exercise, we're trying to dissolve all the objects, outer object, into light, and then all the light dissolve in your body. Then everything in your body, like a heart, the pain in the heart, blockages in the heart. And so you're trying to bring the awareness presence there and dissolve your pain, blockages, physical heart itself, all into the light. So you have a luminous heart. You have light, heart of light. And that these all light gradually gather together and dissolve into one single sphere of light in your forehead. And then that point, you there's nothing. So outer world, all the objects of your weakness, your negative emotions are dissolved into light. There's nothing to focus, nothing to worry, nothing to engage negatively outside there. Inside here, all your body has dissolved into the light. There's nothing negative, pain, blockages to engage either. So what you are, what you experience is a sense of self, is just one single sphere of light in the most kind of energetic place in your forehead. And then gradually you allow that to dissolve into the space. Then you allow yourself to follow sleep. So now when you're following sleep now, at this point, you're not following sleep. You're not falling asleep by drawing attention to your negative things in your office, conflicted person in your workplace, or in your pain in your relationship. No, you're not drawing attention anywhere. So you are just that presence of light. You're presence of that awareness. You are only that. So you are allowing yourself to fall asleep in that presence of light, or presence of that awareness. So that's what is happening here. So that practice is what I would continuously recommend everybody to do it. We will do a short guided meditation after. I'll say a few more things here. The second exercise here is we call tundu. Tundu means like a sending and expanding and retrieving and contracting or receiving back. So this is the second exercise what we're going to do. So we have two exercises, right? So among six, I'm introducing two main ones. So the second exercise is, so as usual, you know, you do your nine breathing or purification. If you know, if you don't know, you do a deep breathing exercise. Breathe deep and use the breath to exhale any discomfort in your body, any discomfort in your energy field, any discomfort in your mind. Basically, you're clearing your body, you're clearing your speech, you're clearing your mind, you are trying to find more clear, open, luminous place in yourself. That's what you're trying to do before you go to sleep. So once you go to sleep like that, or once you did this dissolving into the light practice, so what you feel now, at that point, maybe you feel very, instead of feeling very concrete, substance, inherent, solid, you feel very light. So basically you feel like a sky, you feel like a space, you feel like a light. You feel that space, awareness, and warmth. Basically that's what you're feeling. So you feel that, you're aware of that, you rest that, you go deeper, deeper, deeper into it, and then gradually imagine a home. Maybe later, I don't know if we have any home, Mariella. If you have a home, please post there. If not, we will post it later, a syllable home. So you imagine a small syllable home from inside, from your heart. You're breathing it out, so it's like coming out. And from your nostril, these, your all this, your breath is like a luminous hung. If you don't have luminous hung for now, you can imagine like a light. So light, your breath is light, and you're breathing light, and you're sending light outside, and light is who you are. Your awareness is light. You have body of light. You have a body, speech of light. You have a mind of light. You are light. You are luminous, and you are sending this luminous light as a breath outside your nostril into your own territory, into your own world that you live in, work, you know, or your bedroom, your home, your whatever you are, where you're sleeping, and send this out to specific areas and objects. Again, and you know, like the same thing like before, you're dissolving all the objects of ego pain. So you're sending this light out and just dissolving everything into light, particularly those you are attached, those you are stuck with, those you are have pain relationship with. You dissolve all of them into the light, into hung, luminous hung. So in a way, there is nothing, nothing out there than luminous hung. There is nothing out there than just a light. So hopefully, I hope that you don't have any problem with the hung, or you don't have any problem with the light. So then if that is true, there is, you don't have any problem out there, you know. So some sense of you are not free, you are free. This sense of feeling very free and open when you are looking out there. So when then that same light you breathe in, so you go breathing out, then you breathe in. The light goes in your body, and then every organ, your heart transforms into the light, your lung transforms into the light, your kidney transforms into the light, your liver transforms into the light, your spleen transforms into the light, your gallbladder, and every intestines, every cells in your body, every bone in your body, just everything transforms into a light. Your whole body transforms into light. Your field of energy of speech transforms into light. Your consciousness is light and transforms into light. If you're feeling any heavy, dark, and if you feel like a kind of blocked somewhere in psychologically, they all transform into the light. So now there is nothing there or nothing here than just a pure light. And you're allowing yourself to follow sleep in that pure light. Now imagine, so the differences. Usually we go to sleep not being conscious. We go to sleep not that we guide to go to sleep. We are driven by our thoughts and emotions and weakness and pain and conditions to a specific places in our body where there is a blockages, where there is a pain, where there is a wound. And if we go outward, we get lost in we are sleeping in our bedroom, but our mind is in the office trying to taking care of the mess there, a never-ending mess. So you are out, far, far out there, or you are far, far deep in here in the wounds and pains like that. So this not, how are you going to expect you're going to have a good sleep? How are you going to expect that night will be healing? How you can expect to morning get up in a good mood? No way you can do that, right? So you definitely want some sense of shift and change in the way we are guiding practice here. So now I will do a short meditation, guided meditation, and so that all of you will remember this two exercise to continue to. And again, I'm also asking everybody, those who have been doing last 2 days with the dissolving into the light, and just please tell how things are going so I have some sense of how the practice is going, and give me some sense of where I need to redirect my attention, what I need to speak, where I need to guide the practices, okay? So thank you. So sit comfortably for a moment. Just imagine this is where a time when you're going to go to sleep. You are doing a nine breathing or purification. Any purification breathing exercise you know, it's fine, do that. You are calling the master, the teachers, Yidam, Dakini, the deity, angels, whoever that enlightened beings that you feel that you are, you feel supported. Feel their presence, feel their blessings. And in this particular case, imagine Salje Dudalma, Salje Dudalma. Salje means the one who clears, the one who is clear. Dudal means the one who is pure, perfected, the goddess of the sleep, white, luminous, loving, caring. Feel her presence like a mother to the child as before you go to sleep. So you have all these supports. Feel comfortable. Bring your attention inward. Being aware of the stillness in your body. Being aware of the silence of the speech. Being aware of the spaciousness of your mind. Remember the image of the light. If you are bringing your attention inward in your body, you are aware of your body. That means your body is illuminated that moment. It's awakened, illuminated, it's clear, the stronger presence, the connectedness with awareness. The light represents your awareness. Breathe deep. And of those you are in a country, in the world where you are, it's a time to ready to go to sleep. Just lie down in your bed. Just I'm putting you to sleep this moment, guiding your meditation to sleep, yoga practice. Dissolve all the object, external objects, particularly that last few days, few weeks that you are engaged too much and negatively, pain stories, those people, those objects, situation. Imagine, dissolve all them in light. Just gradually take your time. Instead of seeing that person, see a light. Instead of seeing specific object, see dissolving that into a light. Take your time. and this whole light is all in your body, and then imagine now everything in your body, like if you're sick somewhere, bring your full attention into in that location and transform that sickness into a light, that pain into a light, that blockages into the light. An example again, like I gave example, if you feel wound in your heart, and then this is, you see, transform into the light. If you feel pain in your neck, then you just bring awareness there. Imagine the neck, that pain, blockages, transforming into the light. Just basically every part of your body, organ, intestine, cells, bone, blood, bone marrow, everything transforms into the light. And all those light gather together into a one single sphere of light in your forehead. Take your time, continue. And gradually allow to dissolve that one single sphere of light into the space. In that moment, there's now no object to focus on anything. There is a boundless presence, boundless sacred space that you are aware that you are presence in. You're free. Your light, you feel that sense of freedom, clear, and allow yourself to fall asleep, trusting that sacred space like a mother. It's like a womb of mother, and you're allowing yourself to falling asleep there. That sacred space is the mother, and you're allowing yourself to fall asleep there. Sleeping with awareness can change your life. This can change your life. As you feel complete presence in that space, but you still have your body, just as you're still breathing, so breathe the light out. You are light, you're breathing light, breathe that light out, and transform all the objects once again. If there's remaining, dissolve them into the light, the power of your breath, the power of the awareness of the light of your breath. Transform all the ego object, pain object, object of fear, dissolve them into light. And particularly, it's very personal, so that all the objects that you're struggling with, the people, story that you're struggling with last couple of days, weeks, months, dissolve those people, those objects, those situations into light as you breathe out. You breathe out. When the breath touches those objects, they dissolve into the light. One after another, one after another. Your exhalation is transforming all outer appearances into light. Your exhalation of your breath of light transforming all the pain objects into the light. And the same light comes back, breathe in, then the inner objects of pain or inner places of pain, wound, where healing is needed, they all transforms into the light. So exhalation transforming outer world into light, inhalation transforming inner world into the light. It's continuously process of transforming every appearances, objects into the light. Power of the breathing of light. Continue. And every moment, any moment, if you feel that you're really sleepy, but it's completely okay to follow, allow yourself to follow sleep in this process of breathing. Allow yourself sleep in the process of breathing light, being light, feeling light, breathing light, seeing light. Allow yourself to go to sleep. Okay, so slowly you can open your eye, and those who are already sleeping, bye. So maybe in the probably some places, some part of the world, you are already listening this teaching in your bed, and maybe you're already sleeping. Maybe you did not follow all the guided meditation on the halfway you are gone. Huh? So. That's fine if you already fall asleep. Maybe you're not even hearing what I'm saying right now, so that's not a problem. So I hope that all of you are, it's clear with these practices, and we are, you know, again, we are supporting each other. I'm here to support all of you, and this is what gives me joy. Gives me energy to get ready, prepare these things, and read all of your comments, and seeing all of you how engaged all of you are, how you're participating, and just makes my day seeing somebody is doing better and feeling happier, sleeping deeper, and so on. So. Again, so please give me, again, continuously give me feedback, and we are all committed. I said one thing, nice thing about everybody saying they all are committed. So we all committed. I did my practice yesterday night, and I slept well. I have a wonderful dream because last week I have some not pleasant dreams, and neither that pleasant sleeps. A few nights, so yesterday night was perfect, great. So I am on it, continuing, and I hope that all of you will be very much engaged and continue. And then, as this is the beginning of the sleep yoga workshop, so I would once again, you know, if this is a benefit for you, is a beneficial for you, is a helping you, supporting you, and then. I would like you to be help me and help us here to promote these sites by, you know, obviously liking and also particularly sharing with other with your audience, and then also using social media and let your friends and families know, so that everybody who's sleeping know, so there are a little bit better way to go to sleep, and better, and you're going to go to sleep anywhere. You're not taking time away from anybody, and not taking time away from your work. You're not taking away from time with your partner. You're not taking time away from your children, your wife, your husband. You're not taking time away from anybody. Instead, you're giving great time, great practice, the time and light you're giving to yourself in this sacred sleep yoga practice. So it's the greatest gift that you can give to yourself and to somebody else. So thank you very much, and I look forward to see you all next Tuesday. Bye now.